Brothers and sisters, a very core message of Allah when He sent all of the prophets to establish justice is to worship Allah alone and also to establish the justice in this planet. This is very core message of the all prophets Allah sent in this earth with this message to establish the justice. Justice brings peace, stability, and it helps that people are not causing injustice and not causing bloodshed, and people are getting safety, security, peace in this world. Everybody is looking for that. We have to take every step to secure that we are not causing any injustice. In our individual life, in our family life, in our transaction with others, even in the war field, we need to follow the rules of justice. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded in the Quran that indeed Allah ordered justice and good conduct and giving help to relatives and forbids immorality and bad conduct and oppression. He admonishes you that perhaps you will be reminded. Many of the verses of the Quran is talking about justice. Another ayah, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُكُمْ أَن تُؤَدُّوا الْأَمَانَاتِ إِلَىٰ أَهْلِهَا وَإِذَا حَكَمْتُمْ بَيْنَ النَّاسِ أَن تَحْكُمُوا بِالْعَدْلِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ نِعِمَّا يَعِذُكُمْ بِهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ سَمِيعًا بَصِيرًا. Indeed, Allah commands you to render trust to whom they are due, and when you judge between people, to judge with justice. Excellent is that which Allah instructs you. Indeed, Allah is ever hearing and seeing. So the establishing justice and speaking truth, one of the very important duties of every human being. Allah, even if it goes against you, still stand for justice. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Nisa, ayah number 135, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُونُوا قَوَّامِينَ بِالْقِسْطِ شُهَدَاءَ لِلَّهِ وَلَوْ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَوِ الْوَالِدَيْنِ وَالْأَقْرَبِينَ. O you who have believed, be persistently standing firm in justice. Witness for Allah, even if it be against yourselves or parents and relatives. He also says, وَإِنْ حَكَمْتَ فَحْكُمْ بَيْنَهُمْ بِالْقِسْطِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحَبُّ الْمُقْسَطِينَ in Surah Al-Ma'idah 42. And if you judge between them with justice, indeed Allah loves those who act justly. An opposite of justice is dhulm, which is, it could be translated as injustice, and also oppression. In hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, ittaqu dhulm, fa inna dhulma dhulumatun yawm al-qiyamah. Avoid injustice and oppression. Indeed, injustice and oppression are the darkness in the day of judgment. It will be cause one is suffering, will be responsible in front of Allah to cause injustice and oppression. There are various kinds of injustice could take place. In any area of the life, we have to be always just in the dealing and transaction. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَأَوْفُ الْكَيْلَ وَالْمِيزَانَ بِالْقِسْطِ, that and give full measure and weight in justice. Okay, this is about the transaction, that any kind of transaction should be always justice. We always have justice. Many people will look for chance how to deceive other, how to cheat people in business, in many kind of transaction, writing all these good offer in a very bold letter, but writing below in very small letter what is the terms and condition, that all this offer was almost nothing. This is the way, technique people are using to cheat people sometimes. So Allah said, you have to be just in all kinds of transactions. We can see also injustice taking place in media. Sometimes bringing the image of somebody who is innocent as he is a big criminal. And the criminals are presented as innocent. This is always making truth is false and false is truth. The media can make the story this way. This is, we can see sometimes, in some aspect of the media, that kind of things are clearly, you can notice that how there is all hiding the truth and bringing the falsehood in a way that to convince people what is the opposite of the fact. Also, we can see injustice sometimes, talking about each other, blaming people something they haven't committed, blaming somebody, bringing allegation against somebody, not only in the media, main media, but you see the social media is nowadays more used than probably the other media, mainstream media. Social media playing a role as well. Individually, people are spreading message, bringing allegation against somebody, blaming something, never committing. All these are through sometimes Facebook, Twitter, many other social media, and people are believing all those and making comment and contributing in falsehood, adding something, and thousands of people will be coming to echo and to agree or to disagree, all these kind of things sometimes without investigating the truth and the fact. In this regard, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu in ja'akum fasikum bi naba'in fatabayyanu an tusibu qawman bi jahala fatusbihu ala ma fa'altum nadimin. O you who have believed, if there comes to you a disobedient one with information, which is false information, false allegation, then you investigate, lest you harm a people out of ignorance and become over what you have done regretful. So you realize very late that it was a big mistake to react upon or taking some action against that which you regret later. So this other social media is nowadays, it is a good tool to communicate, but it could be a good tool of destruction as well if people misuse it for the wrong purposes. We can see injustice in another form. People are given death sentences and hanged without following proper process of judiciary. Some people could say these are the judicial murder taking place in many parts of the world, which the courts are established to establish the justice, and they are used as a tool of injustice. This is the disaster mankind is heading to sometimes in some places. Now, we can see this world is becoming more insecure because of many of the war, many kind of the acts of terrorism here and there, as these are bringing more injustice we can see nowadays. You see, suddenly there is shooting taking place indiscriminately, and you are killing people in the shops, in the stadium, in here and there, dozens or hundreds of people will be dying. You can see explosion, bomb explosion in somewhere, killing again hundreds of people. Now we can see the war is started by bombs pounding the cities and villages, killing many innocent people, not targeting only the enemies. This killing indiscriminately, it is a problem of the war. We can see everywhere the many of the civilians, many of the children, women, those are totally innocent, are killed and injured, and whole life they became disabled. If you look at any country, it's gone through the war, this is the if you have the number of the dead people, number of the injured people, number of the people became disabled for whole life, suffering, the homeless, the schools, the hospitals, everything is bombed. Even the hospital bombed, doctor, nurses, patient, everybody is dying. Search for all this area where war is taking place. Okay, so we have to look at the ethics of war. Islam is very careful. If you look at the history of the war in Islam, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, how guiding his ummah, if you go to war, only target is your enemy, not the innocent people. Anybody who is not carrying arms, he cannot be killed. Anybody who is elderly people or children or women, people of the religious the worship places and the worship places itself, all this should be safe. Even the animals has the right of safety and security. Even the trees should not be burned or cut down. All this guidance. Why are nowadays the civilized world will go to war without considering all these and killing the indiscriminately the all people of children, elderly people, the women, destroying hospital and demolishing the houses, whole city, village is turned to ruin. And hundreds of thousands becoming refugees. This is the nowadays phenomenon of the war. So this is injustice. Killing young babies, if you see their images, how you feel? Innocent baby of 1 year, 2 years, these young people are dying, target of the bombs and gunfire. What is it? Such an injustice is taking place in this world. So bloodshed brings further bloodshed. Bloodshed is not the solution. Using bomb is not the solution. We have to find, humanity should look for some kind of alternative steps, means to bring the peace in this world. That is the duty of the mankind. All sensible people should work for that. Wherever you are, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted us, we should be just in ourselves, in our family life, in our dealing and transition with other. Anywhere we live, we should work hard to establish justice. We should not be part of any injustice. We should not cause it, neither allow that it is happening. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq and ability that we do justice in ourselves, with others, and we do try our best to establish justice in this world.